very much. First of all, I'm sorry for my pronunciation. Dostane gerami, hamkarani mehteram, evles heme, mehahem, selam hae germe, khodra, khidmat shoma aziran, terdim nemayen, esteri de shoma, de hemae, merdom cemhuri dizan, keşvere dost ve hemsaye pirizi ve hoşbahtı ağrıdın konu. I am very delighted to be in Kokuzo Study Institute and to address to such a distinguished audience, its first official visit of the Center for Strategy Studies, and the President of Azerbaijan, to the Islamic Republic of Iran. We have met with the experts from Iran in different international platforms, conferences, and forums. Our visit is possible due to the kind invitation of late Dr. Sajadpour, and we express our deep appreciation for the possibility to meet and discuss the processes that are happening in our region with a wide circle of Iranian experts. The current period of history, characterized by chaos of international affairs, has been transforming from unipolar to the multipolar world. Geography puts a high premium on regional leaders who don't want to be a tool of projects of superpowers. The national states have proved that they are the main actors of international politics, and it's too early to write them off. The appearance of transnational threats, such as international terrorist organizations, criminal groups, and drug cartels, have not increased the efficiency of transnational law enforcement agencies. And the brunt of the combating against this phenomenon still falls on the nation states, which unite their efforts against these threats. Globalization has brought integration and acceleration of the processes into our lives, but the world has not become safer and more stable. The interdependence among national, regional, and global security dimensions have accelerated. The unipolar world was caused many precedents of gross violation of international law that have been repeated by other states, which gave rise in new conflicts and wars. The ideologies of states that are considered winners of the Cold War have not become decisive in the world. Liberal intervention failed. Today, the processes taking place in the Western world discredit the path they have chosen. The democratic process of expression is in contradiction with global integration. There was a contradiction between the views of the political and economic elite of the Western world and the population of these countries. Liberal intervention and global domination are challenged not by states that are the target group, but its own population of the West. In the context of the devaluation and free interpretation of international law, nation states pursue pragmatic policies based on their national interests. This year, Azerbaijan celebrated 25th anniversary of regaining of independence. And during these years, we have faced a number of problems and obstacles that are quite natural for the modern world. The occupation of 20% of territories of Azerbaijan by Armenia, ethnic cleansing and more than 1 million Azerbaijanis from Armenia, Karabakh, seven surrounding regions, genocide in Khojaly have become indicators of double standards and crisis of international law. The international community recognized the territorial integrity of Azerbaijan, however, have not attempted real steps to condemn the aggressive Armenia. We live in a world where there are sanctions against nations which have nuclear weapons, but there is not any condemnation and sanctions against Armenia, which occupied our territories and avoids any comprehensive and substantive negotiations to resolve the conflict. Despite all obstacles of the 1990s, the Republic of Azerbaijan has been able to recover and become a regional leader of the South Caucasus. The utmost determinant for successful foreign policy is based on correct understanding of our position in the world, region, and precise formulation and realization of national interests, which are based on history, geography, cultural identification, and natural interests of a state. National leader of Azerbaijan, Heydar Aliyev, launched foundations for right perceptions and realization of national interests of Azerbaijan, and President Ilham Aliyev proceeds and charged with new essences and substances the domestic and foreign policies of Azerbaijan. Our republic has complicated and multi-layered geopolitical identity based on geography, historical, religious, and cultural substances. Geographically, we are in Europe. Religiously, we are a part of Muslim world. Culturally, we are a part of Turkish space. For the recent 200 years, we have been a part of Russian Empire, the USSR, and now CIS. In other words, in fact, we share same religious, geographic, historical, and cultural identities with many Eurasian nations. This fact creates many opportunities, as much as challenges. On the one hand, Azerbaijan participates in all integration processes of all geopolitical identities: Council of Europe, CIS, Organization of Economic Cooperation, Organization of Islamic Cooperation, Turkish Council, Black Sea Economic Cooperation, and others. On the other hand, negative processes in all these platforms affect Azerbaijan directly or indirectly. The countries with such complicated identities should take into account these issues also in domestic policy, since making priority any particular element of the identity can lead to the conflict with other elements. Consequently, it might lead to fragmentation and polarization of the society and conflicts with neighbors. Heydar Aliyev and policy of Azerbaijanism enabled to consolidate the society around common objectives, created conditions for formation of civic nationalism, Azerbaijani nation. At the same time, constructive cooperation with all dimensions of geopolitical identity has become priority. The principles of foreign affairs have been formulated by Heydar Aliyev and President Ilham Aliyev successfully proceeds and realizes. Azerbaijan has not been and will not be battleground of superpowers. At the same time, Azerbaijan pursues the policies that not to create conditions for influencing its domestic political development, since utmost goal of these attempts is to influence and shape the foreign policy of Azerbaijan. And it's unacceptable and unproductive taking into account our geographical position. The next principle of foreign policy of Azerbaijan, which is based on prism, is that there cannot be any threat to the immediate neighbors of Azerbaijan. This principle is voiced by all nations of the world. However, only time and experiences demonstrate the devotion to this principle. In the past 25 years, Azerbaijan has been able to demonstrate to its neighbors that we are sincerely committed to realization of cooperation. Bilateral relations for our country are a priority, and Azerbaijan does not sacrifice its bilateral relations to the third countries. It enables us to cooperate with countries which don't have bilateral relations, to maintain stability in the region, to maintain patience, and not to fall into emotional breakdown during the conflict between the countries that are neighbors and strategic partners of Azerbaijan. Thus, bilateral relations with neighbors, establishing mutually interdependent relations and realization of economic projects are priorities of foreign policy. In this context, the relations with Iran for us play a very significant role and detrimental to some extent. President of Azerbaijan Ilham Aliyev, evaluating our bilateral relations, said that we are very happy that Iranian-Azerbaijani relations are on the rise and developing successfully and rapidly. Our relations have been a solid background. For centuries, our people lived and created together. We are united by history, culture, common past and religion. Our relations are built on this solid background, and now Iranian-Azerbaijani relations reached to the level of strategic partnership. Historical, cultural, linguistic, and geographic proximity of our countries dictate its own conditions of peaceful coexistence and building equal and mutually beneficial relations. Quarter of centuries of peaceful coexistence of our countries has demonstrated that all stereotypes which our force wanted to implant have not reached its goals. Dynamics of our bilateral relations among leaders of our countries, relevant state agencies, expert communities, and representatives of culture demonstrate the high level of relations. The Intergovernmental Commission is one of the most effective mechanisms to promote the deepening of partnership. An important factor in the relations is the human factor. The increasing number of visits of citizens of Iran and Azerbaijan as tourists. The main indicator of the level of bilateral relations between two countries is trade turnover, unfortunately, which is not too high. Our relations have huge potential within, both in public and in private sector, and the end of sanctions against Iran must create more opportunity to increase the trade turnover several times. In 2016, relevant documents are signed by between ministers of communications and information technologies, agencies responsible for standardization, national banks, railways, and customs services that will facilitate economic relations between our countries. Azerbaijan is interested in strengthening relations with Iran since, as President Ilham Aliyev underlined, the development of non-oil sector in the economy is priority, and Azerbaijan is doing everything to increase the export of non-oil goods and products. In this context, the relations with immediate neighbors play strategic significance. The new and perspective direction of in our cooperation is transportation. Historically, our countries have always been on the main traffic arteries of the East-West. On the Eurasian continent, China has been launching a Silk Way economic belt, and the southern route passes through our territories. Iran, as well as Azerbaijan, actively participate as transit countries, also intend to utilize the potential of railways for boosting exporting potential. This year, the President of Azerbaijan signed several decrees that will facilitate the procedures of cargo carriage. The consortiums have been established with the participation of Ukraine, Georgia, Azerbaijan, and Kazakhstan, as well as Turkey, Georgia, Azerbaijan, and Kazakhstan. The synchronization of bureaucratic procedures has been designed that increases the competitiveness of our route. On other hand, on August 2016, in Baku, the North-South transit route was discussed by Iran, Azerbaijan, and Russia, in which India also is greatly interested. Thus, the cooperation in transportation creates conditions and infrastructure for mega-regional projects for the interests of Azerbaijan and Iran. Traditionally, our countries are great exporters of oil and gas. In recent 20 years, Azerbaijan has built large infrastructure to export its own oil to transit of oil of neighboring countries. Currently, the construction of the South Gas Corridor is underway. which one of the largest infrastructure projects that will bring the gas from Azerbaijan to European markets. In the near future, this infrastructure can also be used by neighboring countries, as well as by Iran, to export gas resources to the most solvent European market. Every country is interested in the diversification of international markets for mineral resources, and thus the future cooperation in this direction seems very promising and mutually beneficial. The main and fundamental threat to the stability and security in the South Caucasus and the northern borders of Iran is Armenia, Azerbaijan, Nagorno-Karabakh. As a result of Armenian aggression, 20% of the territory of Azerbaijan is occupied, and more than 1 million citizens of Azerbaijan, as a result of ethnic cleansing, forced to become refugees and internally displaced persons. On the occupied territories, dozens of mosques and historical monuments of Islamic heritage were destroyed. Armenians settled in the South Caucasus in the beginning of the 19th century don't consider the history of the region their own. By rewriting the history of the South Caucasus, Armenia constructed the parallel reality and formulated the state ideology based on Turkish and Islamic hatred. Representing itself as a Christian stronghold and bastion that surrounded by Muslims, Armenians do their best to get support of the Western world, justifying their aggression and occupation of territories of Azerbaijan by expanding their living space. When it comes to dealing with the northern direction, Armenia is using the historical mission, which is main reason of its appearance in the South Caucasus. After all, only the leader of such country in 2013, while making decision to join customs union, could justify it with the security of Armenia. It should be noted that by that time, Armenia had already been a member of CSTO. On the Iranian direction, Armenia utilizes its so-called history and nourishes the stereotypes against Azerbaijan. However, one should not forget that the largest embassy of the United States in the South Caucasus is in Armenia. Though the official spectrum of relations of Armenia and the United States is not extensive to maintain such a number of diplomats in this country, which means that they are also designed not only for Armenia, but for other purposes. The US is a very pragmatic country, and it's very interesting for which merits the United States allocated Armenia with $2.5 billion in recent 20 months. Consequently, the international community does not adequately give reaction to the violation of international law by not implementing the resolutions of the United Nations Security Council. The crisis in Ukraine, Syria, and other parts of the world is a result of inactivity of the UN. In some cases, selective approach. In other cases, ignorance to the implementation of the resolutions of the Security Council. Many countries today speak about the effectiveness of the UN. However, don't make real steps towards improving the image of the organization through implementation of already adopted decisions. This is one of the reasons of increase in number of conflicts and wars. Inactivity of the states of OSCE Minsk Group co-chairs in the last 20 years triggered the escalation of the conflict in Nagorno-Karabakh on April this year. The warlords that fought in Nagorno-Karabakh in the 1990s seized the power in Armenia and seized the source of their power in this conflict. So-called Karabakh generals brought Armenia to bankruptcy and seek to preserve the conflict in its current state. The April escalation between Armenia and Azerbaijan forces in Nagorno-Karabakh demonstrated that these generals understand only the language of force. The escalation has shown that the conflict is not frozen and Azerbaijan will not accept the loss of its territories. It was after the defeat in April Armenia's simulated activity of the negotiation process, but now again took an unconstructive position which leads to the next escalation and another defeat of Armenia. The possible resumption of active hostilities seems to be a necessary measure, since the Armenian leadership seeks to preserve the status quo. The statements that the Nagorno-Karabakh conflict has only a peaceful solution is not accepted by the people of Azerbaijan, since all states that make such statements solve their problems by military means in Syria, Balkans, Afghanistan, Chechnya, and others. Because of the absence of any international sanctions against Armenia, with the exception of Turkey that closed its border because of the occupation of Azerbaijan territories, Azerbaijan has been implementing its own sanctions against Armenia. Our strategic policy in the region is to isolate Armenia from all regional projects, and this policy will continue. This is a deliberate policy of Azerbaijan, since the states that talk about the rule of international law all the time don't take steps to explain Armenia that it's not on the right side of the history. Armenia pushed itself into a situation when it cannot become a transit country for either cargo shipping or for oil and gas. All infrastructure projects require investment that Armenia does not have, and its neighbors are not financial masochists to invest in state local depot from where there is no exit. Another sanctions that Azerbaijan utilizes against Armenia is military advantage over this country that is based accelerated every year. The April escalation demonstrated that the old fortification structure and installation in Nagorno-Karabakh, which Armenians have been building for 20 years, were destroyed only in one day, and the losses of the defensive side were much more than it should be. Azerbaijan, by increasing its military budget, makes Armenia that in deep crisis to spend more than 25% of its meager budget to the army. And it's one of the main reasons of economic crisis in Armenia. Azerbaijan has been undertaking all these attempts and sanctions because we don't see any real interest and activity from the international community. Azerbaijan has demonstrated that it's interested in good neighborhood relations, which have been proven by realization of regional growth. For example, Azerbaijan has invested to the economy of Georgia $3.5 billion. By 2020, we'll invest to the economy of Turkey more than $20 billion. After the lifting sanctions against Iran initiated to deepen relations on broader spectrum, both on bilateral format and the trilateral North-South dimension. We are open for cooperation with Armenia too, also, and offer this respect. The President of Azerbaijan has already underlined that the end of the occupation of territories will open the borders of Armenia with Azerbaijan and Turkey. The Armenians of Nagorno-Karabakh are guaranteed to have a self-government, security, realization of political rights, preservation of the ethnic identity, economic prosperity as part of the Republic of Azerbaijan. And the Armenian and Azerbaijani communities of Nagorno-Karabakh should and will live in this land in peace and prosperity. This is a position of the leadership of Azerbaijan that's based on international law, goodwill, and historical justice. The resolution of the conflict will trigger the development and economic growth of Armenia, and this country will cease to be a source of aggression and international terrorism. The leadership of this country finally will start to think not by the categories and visions of the warlords, but statesmen who think about the future of their people. With this respect, Azerbaijan is satisfied with the position of Iran for its support of the territorial integrity of Azerbaijan and the contamination of Armenia for its policies of occupation within the Organization of Islamic Cooperation. The position of Iran is very important for the regulation processes, since the borders of Armenia with Iran is one of the two oxygen bags for its economy. Iran can become a state who might explain the Armenian leadership that it has a chance to be a part of the civilized world and guided by natural interests of their country and people, rather than the orders of their sponsors, which provide them with arms and finances. Thus, the foreign policy of Azerbaijan can be characterized as realist, productive, and pragmatic, and the realization of which will contribute peace and stability in the region. The Azerbaijani-Iranian relations have promising huge potential for bilateral and regional, as well as global framework of cooperation. The leaders of our countries have strategic vision of development for our countries based on mutual respect and equality. This vision is main guarantee and pillar of good neighborhood lines and friendship between the peoples of our country, which in the current state of global affairs is particularly necessary, not only for us, but also for the region and the world as a whole. For a reason, the great Iranian poet Hafiz Shirazi said, one more time, excuse for my pronunciation. Erafte dusti benşa, ki kamede de bara erat. Nehali düşmani derken, ki bence beş olmadı. Teşekkür ederim.